Hey, it's Necktie. Welcome to episode 130 of Road to 5 Million. And in this one, we're going to start out by taking a load of meat to Fort Stockton. Let's get into it. How many jokes can be thought of their load of meat to Fort Stockton? Also, folks, hopefully the mic isn't picking it up because I sit right next to my window. And it is currently raining like a cow pissing on a flat rock right now. For those of you that don't understand that analogy, if you've never seen a cow piss on a flat rock, it comes down with much force and a lot of it. I'm just thankful it's not snow. Because apparently up in Iowa and north, it is snow slash ice. So that's fine. I'll take rain. Anyway, okay, shut the hell up, Ty. Let's go. Oh, look at that. I didn't plan that, honestly. Oh, I guess as we let the freight shaker warm up, I guess I could update you, huh? So, if you remember, we were in Roswell. I'm not an alien kind of guy, so I had to get out of there. So I fast traveled to Lubbock, to our yard there. And we're taking a load of meat down to Fort Stockton. And then honestly, I'm going to try. Hopefully there's something going to San Angelo around over here so we can get Highway 67 knocked out. That's probably what I'm going to try and do a lot of now. Because we're probably going to hit 5 million here fairly quickly with all the drivers we have. So that's the other thing I need to think of. There's probably going to be a change to the series, meaning the title change. And then it will probably go back to episode 1. I don't know yet. I'm trying to figure all that out in my head and how it makes sense, plus starting a new series from scratch with like a truck and a trailer. I'll set it up to where I have a shitty beat up truck and a trailer on hard economy and go from there. I haven't thought of a dollar amount yet. I haven't thought of any of that. So I know I should have that shit figured out, but I've got a lot of crap going on in my head. Mainly trying to get the new branding done on the trucks for that series, or maybe even coming to this series. I don't know yet. All right, I'll shut up. Which I guess I could start with those signs straight ahead with the new, there's a road here somewhere. Right there. I think there's a fence over here, though, too. Oh, well, let's go. Man, it is darker than the inside of a cow out here, isn't it? Don't worry, folks, it'll buff out. Actually, I don't know if I actually hit that or if I hit a bump, because I think my suspension was slammed. Either way. Oh, also, since the last episode, I verified. Because I actually did, when I fast traveled to Lubbock, it put me in the shop. So I updated the truck because I totally forgot about the light update. I didn't have lights on the side or on the front of the breathers of the truck. And then I shortened the bunk. So it's now a 70-inch bunk, or maybe it's a 74 instead of an 80, or it's a 70 instead of an 84. I don't know. It's the one down from the big one. Anyway, while I did that, I verified the gears I had in this. I said in the last episode that I thought I had 285s. No, I've got 263. So that's, for those of you that may be new here or whatnot, that is why we're going 60 miles an hour in 7 low and only at about 1400 RPM. And I really, episode 131 is probably going to be this truck, but it's not going to be the trailer. Because I would really like to pull something heavy with this truck just to see how well it does. Obviously, out of the gate, you're not going to win a, you know, stoplight to stoplight. But I don't know, I'm liking it, quite honestly. Oh. Go straight. I don't know what y'all are going through in life right now, but I really hope that put as big a smile on your face as it does mine. And bear with me, I still have the synchronized transmission setting off. So I'm getting used to that, which I found out you have to be at a complete dead stop before it goes into gear now. See how it's not going into gear and it's grinding? But as soon as I come to a complete stop, still getting used to it. I'm actually kind of impressed on how this accelerates even with 36,000 pounds. She is definitely a left lane truck all day long, though. Miles an hour, 1500. Getting 6.5 miles per gallon. Drop it into 8 low, stay at that same speed, and we're up to 8-9 miles per gallon.
Keep
road,
right.
Road work ahead. Oh, and I gotta keep right. All right. They appeared to come to a stop really quick. I am also, as the regulars to the channel know, the Cummins Signature 600 is my favorite. This DD60 14 liter. If it's not a 1A, it's quickly moving up to being right on with the Signature 600. Go for it. You'll see my taillights in about a half mile. Shift up.
Keep right. After 50 yards, exit right. Exit right ahead. After 100.
Completely forgot what gear I was in. I also just realized the Truckee app is not up on the top of the screen, and I have no idea why. Starts automatically too, so I don't know, it'll probably pop up after this next load, I would imagine. Speed limit 80. Okay. Don't mind if I do. And 8 low. feeling I'm gonna need that exit.
Keep right.
Yep.
After 50 yards, exit right ahead.
I also have a feeling I need to mess with the average window length some more because this... Now I got the blinker bullshit figured out. Now this micro stuttering bullshit's driving me nuts.
Turn left.
And by driving me nuts, I mean it's literally messing with my eyes. As in giving me a headache. Scam game, man. See, look at that AI vehicle just stuttering across the screen. Shit ran just fine 2 days ago. Haven't changed a thing. The good news is in the 1.47 update, we're getting an update to the ambient sounds. Because that would be the top of my priority if I was the developer of this game. Taking a right back there, we'd be at our Odessa facility. Oh, wow. Thanks, car, for slowing down. Mighty nice of you.
Straight. After 100 yards, turn left. turn left.
I gotta fix my trailer.
After 100 yards, turn left. Turn left. You have reached your destination.
Doesn't get much easier than that, so let's see how we can F this up, huh? Okay, why are my blinkers speeding up again? I literally... Okay. Calm down, Ty. It'll be alright. Freaking game, man. Not very often in this game you actually unload a load where you would normally unload it. Base game even. Alright. Job Marquette. Anything to San Angelo? No, nothing. This is all we have out of here. Oh, that's because I did Walmart. Or is that the only thing here? Hold on. That is the only thing in Fort Stockton is Walmart? I don't want to go to any one of those. Alright, let's take some empty pallets back to his house. I'm probably hitting the button to get loaded. Because now I'm gonna have to back up. Yeah, head towards your marker. I was just there. Although it doesn't want me there, does it? Okay, fine. We've got the room here, so let's just do this then. Whopping 27,000 pounds of, I guess Truckee says 26,455, whatever. It's 27,882 according to the game. Oh, plenty of room. Out, folks.
Turn right. Turn left.
You know, the more I play this game, the less shit like that even baffles. I mean, it doesn't even faze me anymore. You can approach an intersection and not even be out in the intersection and AI traffic will stop. I was clearly out in the lane and then truck just appears out of nowhere and wants to run into me. And for anyone wondering why I didn't get fined, I do have my fines on. However, I'm running a mod that adjusts that stuff. So it has to depend on whether or not a cop is around, and it adjusts all that percentage shit. So that's why I didn't get fined for that jackass running directly into me when I did nothing wrong. That's why we did. I think. guess I should have maybe taken a right there. To pick that part of that loop up, but oh well. These graphics. Okay, this whole synchronization of the transmission thing is kind of stupid. Like, why wouldn't you let me go into fourth gear there? Thank you. Where are those panels going, I wonder? And coils. These graphics are pissing me off so much right now. I'm probably gonna work on that before editing this video. Okay. Just wanna make sure. I lost it in my mirror. Sad part is it's 1 PM and I gotta frickin' sleep. Which means it's gonna be nighttime. I need to get back on a different cycle. Oh, that's with my trailer. Coil's going to Holbrook. Damn, that's going to Coraline. It's going to Gallup. Sad part is that expires in 6 hours. I need to sleep. So, let's do this. Dismiss. Success. Trigger should be somewhere here, I think. Okay, so it doesn't want to hit it this time. It's my one gripe on this yard. Is even though the bed icon is over there, you have to drive around this damn thing. And then it's hit or miss on when it actually wants to give you the prompt. So see how I'm like right over the icon? Now I passed it. Between the graphics and the blinker bullshit returning and this, I'm just having a hell of a time. See? Why is it popping up over there now? Normally it pops up over on the other side. Anywho. Now it's midnight. If I sleep again, it's going to be 10 in the morning. And we're already at 2 million. All right, so let me do this. Job market, freight market. Now what's coming out of here? Concrete tubes to Elko. Those are still going to Holbrook. £34,000. Or the coils, 32. Oh, that's 42,000 going to Lubbock. All right, how about we take the loader? See how this girl does with the loader for 131. Didn't really want to go to Beaumont, but is what it is. So we'll get loaded. Take job. Trailer's ready. Need more go-go juice. Dude, I ain't got time for you to get back in the truck, so. There she be, folks, and I just realized something that I need to go correct before the next episode is I had the airlines coming out the back, so they're all jacked up right now, but that will be fixed for the next episode. If he remembers to do it. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, episode 130 comes to an end. If you made it this far, I appreciate you. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And don't forget to drop a like on the way out. And until the next one, y'all take care. Bye.